Morning students, we saw standard formulas in last class. Now we will take some question based on that. I put example number 8, which looks very same. Look at the question. 1 upon x square minus, it was 16. So what is the thing? You will write 16 as 4 square. And now try to compare this given situation with the formula. And the formula is, we know that we have a formula 1 upon x square minus a square dx is equal to 1 upon 2a log of x minus a upon x plus a. You just have to follow the formula and whatever the answer is coming is your final answer. Look at 1 upon x square minus a square. So a will be 4. The formula is 1 upon 2 into 4 log of x minus 4 upon x plus 4 plus c, and that's an answer. 4 to the 8 you can write, and that is over the question. Okay, so this was very simple, but why this simple question is important? Because when you will do often, you will definitely that help you to remember the formulas, because you know that in these 7 formulas student always get confused, that you know that furthermore we have to see with 3 more formulas and all 10 will looks very same, so that these small examples are very important. Okay, let me take one more question. We have from the exercise 7.4. now student, don't think that why I skip all the examples, because same kind of questions I know that what to make first, and then after I'll turn with some different pattern, then I'll go on a few rest example which actually I left right now. Okay, so question number 1, what it says, it is looking 3x square upon x to the power 6 plus 1. This is the question. So now you are thinking that till now we had seen all the formulas which is actually that having 1 upon term with under root, without under root, but it is not 1 upon, so you don't afraid, it is x square, it is x to the power 6. So try to make some relation between these two, and I tell you that how to treat this kind of problem. You write x to the power 6 as x to the power 3 to the power 2 to the power 2, and then after you let x to the power 3 as a t. Try to understand. X to the power 3 equal to t. And do the differentiation. 3x square dx is equal to dt. As usual we did till now. And can you catch that 3x square dx has similar? So these two will be replaced by dt upon this x cube meaning t square plus this is 1. So whole situation has been turned 1 upon 1 plus t square dt. And I taught you the thing, if you remember, I taught you the thing that whenever 1 upon 1 plus t square is coming, it is standard one, tan was t. If you don't remember the formula, no matter, you can write 1 upon t square plus a square. You also can write 1 is 1 square. And the formula is 1 upon a tan was x upon a. So also you can use, but please admit my thing that 1 upon 1 plus t square is standard one, and remember there's a tan was t. It's a tan was t and plus c. So further is your job, put t equal to x cube and get your final answer. So this was the question. Similar we have, let me tell you that very similar we have few question of the exercise, like a fifth one and question number sixth one. So both are very same, which is that only fifth and sixth. Okay, I just tell you eighth question, which is actually very same, but still I wanna tell you about this question. This is x to the power 6 plus a to the power 6. This is the question. So how to do this, how to deal this problem? Same, x to the power 2 upon that x 6, you will write x cube whole square plus a, you also write same. Don't bother about that, it's constant value. Main is a variable x cube and I am going to take x cube as equal to t. The meaning of that 3x square dx is equal to dt. And look at student, x square dx are waiting for replacement. So x square dx will be dt by 3. And go on your question that x square dx will be dt by 3. And that is x cube which is equal to dt square. And this is looking very awkward, a cube and square. For bit conveniency, a cube equal to, we consider b. You don't afraid about the condition. That was a variable consideration. I did used to work. But this is just for convenient work. That a cube square, which is constant square. So I, for while, for instant, I assumed a cube equal to b. So that it looks b square. Afterward, when I get an answer, definitely I will change. So the situation now, 3 is not a problem. 3 will come out as it is. And the situation is looking t square plus constant square. And what formula you're going to use here? Look at, I am writing the formula in the form of x because we read all the formulas in the form of x. So we know that we have a formula that x square plus a square, that was a formula, that is log x plus same. Student, you must remember the formula, otherwise nothing will happen, right? Nothing will happen, right? 1 upon x square plus a square equal to log x plus same word is very important because as it is you will copy it. So that same word I am using. So use it now. I equal to, that is 1 by 3 was running here. And if I will write here log instead of x because the formula I wrote in the form of x. But the question is in the form of t. So you will write t plus same meaning t square plus b square. And plus c, that's an answer. Ultimately what you will write, you know that instead of t I'm writing x cube, this is x cube. Instead of b I wish to write a cube, meaning a cube square meaning a6, and plus c, and that's an answer of the question. So hope you have got. I don't think there's a trouble. It's very simple it is. But 5th and 6th is your job, as I taught you recently, that similar kind of question, 5th and 6th. Okay. Now, I want to put the question number 2nd of the exercise. It is 1 upon 1 plus 4x square. So, let me tell you, it is again coming 1 upon. So, okay. It is 1, again in our favor. Maybe some constant, don't worry. But this is actually not a single x square, having some coefficient with this. So you don't afraid. You go with 1 upon 1 plus that 4, you can write 2x whole square. And try to understand that 1 also can be written 1 square. Now can you go with the formula? You don't afraid again. I can tell you that this is a linear form. No? So as x square, same as it is a 2x square. So you don't afraid. The coefficient of x is very important. Ultimately, it will come in denominator after doing the integration. Okay. So, what is the formula? 1 upon, that in curly bracket I am using, I am writing the formula. That 1 upon, this is called a square plus x square. You also can write 1 upon x square plus a square. What you can write? X square plus a square. And the formula is log x plus same. Recently, I taught, I made, you write there only. That is 1 upon x square plus a square equal to log x plus same. You know this is my x square and this is my a square. So this was a formula. And a square plus x square also have the same meaning because in between plus there. So you can write vice versa. Like I equal to, you will write here log. Answer I am writing because the formula I have written. I am applying the formula here. So log x plus same. So don't worry. And don't afraid, this is not, this is x for that, but this is my 2x. So I write 2x plus same meaning as it is, 2x square plus 1 square and plus c. But this is not enough, you have to go whole upon 2 because coefficient of x was 2. That is very very important. When the linear term of x is coming, it is not x but it is a different term of x with the linear form, definitely coefficient of x will come in denominator. From the beginning we are studying that.
Okay.
So in I'll write 1 by 2. Don't afraid that 1 by 2 is a part of formula, but it is the part of the coefficient of x which we have to write in denominator. So half log this plus c, and that's an answer of the question. So hope you've got. I don't think this is a tough one. Question number 3 is very same. I tell you that it is 1 upon, you know, 2 minus x squared plus 1. So question is already prepared and nothing worry, you have to use only the formula. Let me explain one thing, that this 2 minus x is a linear form of x. So read x squared instead of that, you can catch the formula easily. 1 upon root over root, this is x squared plus a squared. So I don't think it's a trouble. Now you can write that one is I equal to, that is 2 minus x whole square plus it is a square, you know, 1 square, sorry, 1 square. And now it's a formula, 1 upon x square plus a square, you know, 1 upon x square plus a square equal to log x plus same. So fortunately in previous 3 questions the same formula is appearing. So keep remember, the same is also, it came here. So it's a formula, plus c, don't write, it's a formula only. Now I'm using it. Look at it. This is x, it is a linear form of x. So both called same, both considered same. Okay, so for your answer is log x. So you don't write x, because it's a for the x. But instead of x, what you're having? 2 minus x. So you will write here 2 minus x plus same, meaning same, copy. Plus c. But it is not enough. It is not. Why? Because coefficient of x is minus 1. Minus 1. So you have to write minus 1 in denominator. So it looks awkward to write minus 1 in denominator. You only write minus here. Minus here. You know, you don't think that that it is it will get confused. No. If you have a good concept regarding the integration, no matter you are using minus sign, you will definitely come to know that from where it came. So it's very simple. So ultimately you got an answer. Okay, so let me move on some other question. Putting a fourth one now, 9 minus 25 x square. So hope till now you have got the concept. Try to understand the denominator. It is actually quadratic, but you know that it is not x again here. It's a constant value. So 1 upon is very important. So I would try here to convert the situation according to the formula. So 9, I will write 9 as 3 square, and that 25x square is 5x whole square. And now read, it is 1 upon a square minus x square. You know? So formula now you are going to use, 1 upon over root a square minus x square is sine inverse x by a. Formulas are very important, no tricks at all. You just have to practice. Then you can understand the formulas. So again I repeat my sentence that write all the formulas, that standard formula on a single page. And then whenever you are making the questions, keep it in front of you and do the questions. Take the help as many possible, no matter at all. And slowly you will definitely be the master in that. Okay. 1 upon a square minus x square equal to sine inverse x by a. Go on that. Your answer is sine inverse x. Instead of x, you will write 5x. Upon a is a 3, but it is not enough. Coefficient of x is only 5. Don't write minus 5. Coefficient of x is a 5. So 5 will be coming in the denominator side. So it's a 1 upon 5 and plus c, and that's an answer of the question. So hope you got. Nothing worry about that. Question number 9 looks very same. I equal to sec square x upon, that is 10 square x plus 4. This is looking again a very simple question. For practicing concern, I'm telling you, student. This will come on, it will either come or not, no matter at all in exam, but okay, for practice concern, I'm telling you. That 10 square x plus 4 it is, na? So you will write, let 10 x equal to t. Look at very important, that is 10 x equal to t. You know, you should understand from your side that The differentiation of tan x is sec square x, which is waiting here in the numerator side. So it's good to take tan x equal to t. Do the differentiation, sec square x dx equal to dt. Now what you will write? I equal to sec square x dx is equal to dt upon that is t square plus that t, tan x equal to t. And at 4, same. And try to change the situation according to the formula. 1 upon that is t square plus 2 square. Now it looks like a formula. What formula? 1 upon x square plus a square. Fortunately, again, log x plus same. Now, till now you have got the concept. Now, use the formula and get answer. So, I equal to, your answer is log t plus same plus c. And write t is equal to 10x and 2 2s are 4. That's the answer of the question. So, these were the 9 questions of the exercise 7.4. Now, in the upcoming questions, the concept is gonna change, little bit change. So before doing anything, I will just teach you how you can convert to any quadratic polynomial in complete square, perfect square. It is nothing special because you already have studied that in a class 10th, completing the square method in quadratic equations. So same I'm using. Look at the situation. This is suppose x square plus 5x plus 7. This is a quadratic term. I am not telling you any question of the book. I am teaching you only, I am telling you only that how we can convert any quadratic polynomial in complete square term. You know, one can understand that it cannot be written complete square. Instead of that, if you have like that, so one can understand that it can be written x plus 2 whole square, it is complete square. But instead of that, if you supposed to have the 5 and 7 suppose, so one can understand that it cannot be written directly in a complete square form. So we should know that how we can turn. And this is very easy because completing the square method you already have studied in class 10th as well, in sometime in class 11th also. So look at it is a plus sign, so definitely one should understand that we have to follow this formula. Look at the formulas very sincerely. When it is a plus sign, you will use this formula. If it is a minus sign, you will use this formula. This formula. So I don't think that it's a trouble. It's a trouble. This time I'm using this formula. And student, try to understand me that you will turn each and every situation in this form. In this form. So how we can do? Look at it. It is a square. So your is a is x. So it's x square. So both are looking equal, x equal to a. Now don't look here because you know that you have to convert the situation in this format. So follow that one only. That one only. It should be balanced, but follow from here. A square is my x square. Now it's a 2. So I will write 2. And don't get surprised that it was a 5. Why I've written 2? Because I want to convert the situation in this format. Okay. Meaning will not change, student. 2, written A. So A was your X. A was your X. Write your X. Now I have to choose B. So B is always half of the coefficient of X. B is always the half of coefficient of X. How we can make half? Divide by 2. So this is B I will choose from my side, 5 by 2. Always half of coefficient of X. Now can you see the term? It is looking 2ab as well as when 2 and 2 will cancel, answer will be 5x same. So I don't think that I need to repeat. Okay. Plus I don't look 7. Look at b square I need because I want to make formula. So b square, what is your b? So b was 5 by 2. So write plus 5 by 2 square, b square has come. So it is in a plus, but 5 by 2 square is not here. So, okay, balance from your side. It is plus 5 by 2 square you wrote because you wanted to make the formula. You wanted to make the situation same according to the formula. You need b square. Okay, 5 by 2 square you have added. So, you have to subtract 5 by 2 from your side. Should be balanced now. Balance now. And lastly, plus 7 is waiting still to write. So, plus 7 I have written here. Now, student, can you see first three terms?
It is looking a square plus 2ab plus b square.
It's a formula. What formula it is?
A plus b whole square. So write these three terms as a plus b whole square. A is x and b is 5 by 2 square. So these three now compiled, or these three terms has been changed in the formula x plus 5 by 2 whole square, and these two will be 5. 5s are 25 by 4 plus 7. Take an LCM student, 5 by 2 square, 4 7s are 23 by 4 in addition sign. Now I will tell you in question, no matter at all whatever you got the formula, but what the important thing that in the quadratic term, how we can quadratic term change in the formula pattern. So okay, tomorrow I'll do the question from direct. No concept now will be told, because today I have taught everything. Okay, so do the practice till question number 9, and in the reference book, if you are getting some other question, please do them, because it will help you to keep remember the formulas. Thank you.